Hi, welcome to Cativi 5 video tutorial. It's another user wish. It's a fan impeller. Okay, so let's have fun with Cativi 5. So let's start with a sketch. Sliding sketch. Do hide these. As usual, if you wonder why, just watch my Cativi 5 basic videos. There's one about these elements. And I need a profile, and that profile would look something like this. It's closed, and of course I will delete those parallel constraints. And this should be a center line, and now add some constraints. This should be a diameter. This would be 160. This should be another diameter. This would be 150. Distance should be 100. This distance 5, and that radius would be 75. Let's see if it moves up or down. That's what I was afraid of. So let's redo and move this point a little. Yeah, that's not possible. So so I will do it like this. Put this right there. That as well. Now let's try to move this point up. Really, that's not possible. It's kind of odd. 7.5. Now it's okay. I could do that, fill it in 3D as well, of course. Now let's make a shaft, 360 degrees, and confirm. Now I want to use a shell, I want to remove that face, and then the thickness should be 5 millimeter. Looks pretty good. I need a plane. That plane should be an offset plane from that one, and the distance is 80 millimeter. Now I want to do a sketch on that plane, so go for sketch, doesn't matter the orientation, height as usual, all these elements. And I need two lines, so maybe turn it around and cut to sketch plane, or the other way around, like this. That's more like it. and I need two lines. One. Two. These should be symmetric to the y-axis, and there should be a distance between them, and this should be 15 plus 10, I suppose. That would be, yeah, 25. And these should be perhaps symmetric as well. Give it a length, that might be 180, and this one as well. Now leave that sketch, and now I want to make a stiffener. I want to use a stiffener, so let's go for that stiffener. That would be from top, yes, with those two would be neutral fiber, and that would be 10. Okay, now I have to make a pocket and another pocket. So I need another sketch on that plane right here. Cut the sketch plane and hide these. And that would be a rectangle. And of course, it's kind of tedious, I know. Delete these and make it symmetric. Make these symmetric as well. Give it a dimension. This might be 35, yeah, and that should be, yeah, I don't want to project those, so we'll draw another circle, give it a dimension of 140, and make it coincident to those axes. Make it for construction only. And I need a line. I could project, I will project that edge, because it's convenient. Usually I don't project those edges, but it's easier, it's faster to do. And that distance from that point right there, this would be 45. So why is this? Oh yeah, I see. So I need maybe a constraint which should be parallel. Okay, leave that sketch, and I want to make a pocket with that sketch up to that face, and this doesn't work because that's not the complete face. It doesn't work. Take a look. I want to make a pocket with that sketch in the other direction, and that pocket should go up to next. Or does it work? Let's take a look. See, that doesn't work. And if you do it maybe, let's delete it and do it once again, you will see it doesn't work up to surface as well. What I need therefore is I have to extract that surface, and I will switch to Generative Shape Design and make an extract. That's right there, and I want to extract that surface. Confirm. And you see, I have to do the extract before I do those stiffeners. So let's go before with Define and Work Object, and then make an extract with that surface right here. And now I can make a pocket. A pocket with that last sketch would be sketch 3, yes. Reverse direction and make it not up to next but up to surface, up to that extracted surface, and this works. And hide that surface. See? Now another sketch, maybe on the same plane, on this one, and yeah, cut, hide these. This would be a circle and a rectangle, and again I have to delete these. Now let's give it a dimension. That would be 40. This distance would be 10. That distance is 16. Now let's move these elements a little bit. Okay. This would be symmetric to that axis. These two would be symmetric this one, and seems I have that would be not 10 but 15. That circle is 40, yes, I did this already. So what's missing? Oh yeah, the center point of that circle should be on that axis, coincident on the other one as well. Well, now let's trim. Leave that sketch. And now let's make another pocket. In this direction up to last. Okay. Looks pretty good. Yeah. Now I think I will need another extract, so let's switch to GSD, and I need a sweep as well. I could do it with a rip, but I will use a sweep. I need an extract of that surface, and that should be propagated tangent. Okay, another extract. Now I need a sketch, and that sketch would be on this plane right here. Superpositioned one. And swap. Okay. Hide these. Cut. And this would look something like it's a line and -90°. Radius. So this should be right there, coincident. There would be an angle. This should be 95. This radius should be 30. This distance should be for construction only, and that point should have a distance, and that would be 100, and that point should be on that axis as well. Coincident. Leave that sketch. Now let's project that sketch, which is not quite visible, so change it to a different color and make it with a different strength, or maybe like this. Okay. Now let's project this one along a direction, projection, that sketch. Not normal, but along a direction that would be the normal to that plane. Nearest solution, there should be two solutions. So direction, not support, sorry, that would be the support. And direction would be this one, and there should be, yeah, okay, so deactivate nearest solution and go again and use an extract and use this one. Okay. Now I could hide that sketch. You might insert another geometrical set and order these elements. So go for another geometrical set and say that's surfaces or faces, surfaces, and father would be the part itself, and move those extracts right there, and you could rearrange them to a to sort, yeah, then they are in the historical order. Okay, should I do a sweep or should I go for a rip, and what kind of sweep? So I could do a line sweep. Let's check it out. Go for a sweep, go for a line, make it with a reference surface. Guide curve would be this, reference surface would be that extract right here. That should be extract 4. Now it's extract 3. Yeah, because extract 4 was that line, of course. Well, that curve. And the angle to that would be 90 degrees. Yeah, and I need a length. So go for, that would be 55. Okay, very nice. Now let's hide that extract and that extract, and let's thicken this. So go back to part design and see if I can thicken that. So thicken, okay. Let's do it 1 millimeter in one direction, 1 millimeter in the other direction, and that would be the face. Yeah, looks good. So if I would do that in a different body, then I could pattern the body. So let's move this thick surface into a new body and see if it works. So I might, yeah, I think it will not work. I will try insert a new body. Well, it did. So now I could make this the body which is in work, and make 2 fillets. By the way, hide that sweep. Make 2 fillets with 20 millimeter and just take this edge right here and that one right there. Confirm. That's okay. And now I could try to pattern this body. So go for a circular pattern. And I need a complete crown. I need 12 instances. And the reference element would be the set axis. Pattern the current solid. Yeah, that's okay. And it's already assembled. If I go right there and say define work object and I'm done. Okay. So hope you enjoyed this one. If you liked it, please give it a like or leave a comment. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Please subscribe, please to my Facebook cat fan page, because I want to get more subscriptions and likes on Facebook as well. Thanks for watching. See you to the next one. Bye bye.